Howdy folks, welcome back. Thanks for joining us again. Today we're talking about propylene glycol. You know, like the stuff I just put in my car today because the coolant was low, that propylene glycol. No, wait a minute, another propylene glycol. Propylene glycol that you may be eating in a lot of everyday foods, shown here. Look at these delicious looking treats. These little donuts that you might find at your office. Or this everyday looking birthday cake. Come on, prep, stay put. Or these delicious looking brownies that if your wife had or spouse had a hard day, she wanted to cook some up. But look, it's kind of in the name, devil's food. It's got all of these have propylene glycol. Let's talk about what that might entail. So why, might you ask, is propylene glycol so prevalent in some of these delicious looking snacks? Well, it helps keep stuff squishy, nice and fresh, a little fresher for longer, half preservative, and it keeps more moisture in the product so it doesn't dry out on you. You know, you don't want to break a tooth or something when you're crunching on your donut. So, sugar, step aside. Propylene glycol has been shown to cause irregular heart rhythms in kids, also kidney dysfunctions, and heck, it's even flammable. Who wants that in your food? I don't. Propylene glycol, this hidden little nasty booger, has also been linked to seizures, severe neurological symptoms, you know, stuff in the noggin that we don't want going on, nausea, vertigo. Vertigo? Come on, Alfred Hitchcock, where are you at, bro? Who do we got now? Harvey Weinstein? Oof. Anyways, look into this, figure it out, start reading labels. You might want to eliminate this from your everyday snacking habits. Guys, as always, like, comment, and subscribe. Drop us a comment below, especially if you have a food group or item that we haven't discussed that you'd like us to check out. We're going to push out more videos to you guys on the Standard American Diet, or SAD for short. Thanks. We'll see you next time.